Yes, good morning to all. So this is our second session of this complete steps RCDC Excel training program. And some of part of this training we have completed in the last session. So can we recall what we have done in the last session and what things you were understood in the last session? So what things we have discussed?
So we have learned a few methods, type of template, and EIM method.
EIM method, okay. So in this situation, either see offset point method is not in use, first thing. Second thing, quick template method, ETABS quick template method is there. Means using the ETABS quick template, you can prepare the grids in the software itself. Okay, so the second method and third method is export and import method. You have to export the drawing, or you can say the center line, from the CAD, and that you have to import in the ETABS software. Okay, so I just want to know, in this situation you have to use the ETABS quick template. In which situation you have to use the EI method? Can you tell me, Salman?
Sir, when the geometry is uniform, we can use uniform grid method or non-uniform. Okay. Sir, when the model is very complicated, so we use the import method.
Yes, exactly. So it depends all on actually the geometry. If your architecture plan is simple geometry, simple architectural arrangement is there, simple plan is there, so okay, you can go with the ETABS quick template. You can prepare the grids in the software itself. But if your geometry is so much complicated, it is not easy to execute, prepare the grid in CAD and then to prepare the grids in software itself, then you have to simply export the drawing from CAD, and simply you have to import the drawing in ETABS. So that we have to practice here now in this session. So we will wait for more 3 minutes. So exactly at 11:10 we will start the session, so that others will also join the meeting. Okay, so we can discuss what other things we have seen in the last session. So there we have seen what is the introduction of ETABS software and what is the use of ETABS software. That also we have seen. And welcome screen. If you are going to open the software with internet connection, without of internet connection, that we also have discussed. So that all was the discussion we have done in the last session. So actually it is, as you can see, very simple structural framing plan is there. So if this kind of structural framing plan is there, so you can directly put the grids over the architecture, over the structural framing plan, and in reference of these grids, in reference of this structural framing plan and center line that is passes through the centers of the column, you can prepare these grid lines in the software. So that is what ETABS quick template method and ETABS quick template option. Okay, so go back to the ETABS and open this software. Okay, just go to file, say new model. Once you click over the new model, you all are well aware with these all three options: use saved user default setting, use settings from a model file, used in built-in setting width. So we need to go with this third option. Now come back to this structural framing plan and this grid reference. So can you tell me what is the unit of this architecture plan or a structural framing plan?
Feet and inches.
Unit system you have to choose. Either US customary will be there or metric SI will be there.
US customary
will be there. So this first option we need to choose, and other rest of all the options will be as it is. Steel section database will be Indian. Steel design code will be IS 800-2007. Concrete design code will be IS 456. So there's no further discussion about this window. This dialog box. Let's say okay. Once you click over the okay, so how many grids are there in x direction? Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So total 8 number of grids in x direction is, so put it as 8. And total number of grids in y direction, how many number of grids are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 grids are there. A spacing of grids in x direction. So let me know whether it is uniform grid spacing or non-uniform grid spacing.
Non-uniform.
Exactly, it is a non-uniform grid spacing. That's why the spacing, the let it to be as it is. Whatever here it is present, means value is present, let it to be as it is. Don't need to change. Just go to custom grid spacing and go to edit grid data. Once you click over the edit grid data, so the thing is what? Two options are there, like display grid data is ordinate, display grid data is spacing. So let me know which one is the means more effective for working. First one or second one?
Second
one. Exactly. Second one. So we have to grow, means proceed with the second option. Choose this one. Now go back. The distance between A to B in difference of A, the value will be what? 10 feet. Just go back and put it as 10 feet. Is that all okay? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Next to that, it is 10 feet 3 inches. Go back. How you can write these values? Just put 10 feet and 3 inches. Just say enter. Is that all okay?
Yes, sir.
Go back to next. 5 feet 9 inches. Just put it as 5 feet and 9 inches. Just say enter. This is all done. Next, 1 feet. Simply 1. Next to that, 10 feet 6 inches. 10 feet 6 inches. Just say enter. And next one, 2 feet. Put it as 2 feet. Next to that, it is 9 feet 9 inches. Put 9 feet and 9 inches. 9 feet, 9 inches. Is that all clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, next, in y direction, what is the spacing? 1 to 2, it is 6 feet 6 inches. It will become 6 feet. 6 feet 6 inches, it will be. Then, next to that, 7 feet 3 inches. So, whatever the values and grids you are going to put here, that is means in this window you can see what the modification is going to be done, how your grids is going to be means change. You can see from here. So if any kind of mistake is going to be done by you, so this will be appear here. This will be appear here. You can see that it is the there is some mistake, so you can correct it. Is that all clear? Hello.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah, 6 feet 6 inches, 7 feet 3 inches, 7 feet, and it is 3 inches. Next to that, 4 feet 9 inches, 4 feet, and this will be 9 inches, center, and next to that, 15 feet, totally it is 15 feet, this is all done. So the grid is now ready. And I would like to make choose some dark, say clear, just say okay. Let the bubble size as it is 660. If you want to change it, let's say I would like to make it as 40. Okay, then say okay. This is all done. Is that all clear? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Now next thing that we have to discuss here, how you can decide the levels. If you are going to deal any real life project, so how you can decide the level? That was the last day of discussion, but due to means time, we are not able to discuss this point in the last session. So what does mean by these levels? It is asking about number of stories. It is asking about typical story height. So what does mean by the typical story height? So what does mean by the bottom story height? and how you can put these values. So for example, this is G plus 3 building. What? Hello? For example, it is G plus 3 building. So this is your foundation level and this is the residential building. This is your ground level. This is your ground level. And this is what? Your plinth level, I would like to say. Hello? This is my plinth level. Now it is the first. This is the second. Now this one is the third one. This one is the third one. So this is the ground floor. This is your first floor. And this is your second floor. Okay, let's say this is G plus 2 building. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It is G plus 2 building. Okay. We have to understand how you can decide the number of stories. What does mean the typical story height? And what does mean by the bottom story height? That we are trying to understand. So, okay. See, first of all, tell me, this level and this level, two levels are there. This is the, let's say, this is the x1 and this is by the y1. x1 and x and y. I just want to know, for the first floor, hello, you all are with me or not? Very important question. Yes, I'm going to ask. You all are with me? Yeah. Yes. Give me answer. For the first floor, which one is the slab? Either this one is the slab or this one is the slab actually. Tell me. For the first floor, which one is the slab? Either this one or this one.
Why
is the slab for the first floor? Hello?
First floor. Yes, sir.
Okay. Anyone else?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Tell me.
For the first floor, why is the roof slab, sir?
Yes, Vagnesh, tell me.
For the first floor, why is the roof slab, sir?
Roof slab.
X will be the floor slab.
X is the floor slab, okay. Ibrahim?
This is the ground floor slab, sir.
X1?
Ground floor slab.
No. What I'm asking, for the first floor, which one is the slab? Either this is the slab, X, or Y is the slab?
Y is the slab.
Y is the roof slab and X is the floor slab, sir.
Floor slab, floor. Yeah. Asif, what do you think?
Y1 is first floor slab, sir.
First floor slab, okay. Wajahat, what do you think?
Yes, sir. Y rahega.
Y rahega, okay. Salman, what do you think? Pratik?
Sir, X.
Y, sir.
Pratik, Y, X. Okay. Vivek?
X is
so X and Y both are slab.
Yeah, both are slab, but for the first floor, which one is the slab?
Y, sir.
Almost those who said that Y is the slab for the first floor, they are wrong. Actually, the slab for the first floor is actually X. This level is the slab for the first floor and this is the roof slab. This is actually the roof. This is actually the roof. Okay. So for the ground, or you can say for the for the ground floor, this plinth level is actually the slab. This and this X is the roof for this ground floor. This Y is the roof for your first floor. And if you are saying that, okay, as per your answer, if this is the slab, if this is slab. Okay, if suppose this is the slab for second floor, so we don't need to put anything about that. But actually, what? For the second floor, we need to put one more slab over to that as a roof. As for shed. Okay, so this is the slab over the second floor. The roof for this second floor and will act as a terrace level. Are you getting my point? So, don't do the mistake. The bottom level is actually the slab for that particular floor. Is that all clear, Pratik?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, always. So, the point is what? How you can decide the number of story. Number of story. So, always, in general, what you have to do? Suppose G plus 2 building is there. Suppose G plus 2 building is there. So, this number you have to add two more. In this number, you have to add two more value. So it is going to become what? Four numbers. So total number of stories will become what? Hello?
Four.
How? See, if you are going to means count the levels, like this is your ground level, this is your plinth level, this is your first floor. So I am going to call it as first. I am going to call it as second. Now I am going to call it as third. Or I can say terrace. I am going to call it as terrace. So this is what? This is the first, this is the second, and this is the third. And in ETAP software, we are not going to model separately ground and plinth. We are going to merge these two levels. What? We are going to merge these two levels and we are going to directly take the height up to the plinth level. Very important point I am going to take. Hello? Wajahat?
Sir.
Okay. In ETAP software, we are not going to model the ground. Okay. Directly, we are going to take the plinth. We are going to merge this level. We are going to merge these two level, and the next height we are going to consider up to the plinth level. So from the foundation to the plinth level, this we are going to call it as a bottom story height. Hello.
Yes, sir.
What we are calling? We are going to call it as bottom story height. So now, okay. Forget this level, foundation level, forget this. So only this, so this will be the first level. This will be the two floors. Suppose two floors are there. So this one, this two. So one additional as plinth, one additional as plinth, and one additional terrace. That's why we are going to add two numbers. Hello, are you getting why we are going to add two?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So one for plinth, one for terrace. These two additional number will be there in between this number of floors. Suppose G plus 100 floors are there, just for example. So how many number of total stories will be?
102.
102.
102. Okay. It will become 102. If suppose G plus 7 floor building is there. So initially, how many number of levels you need to put?
Nine.
Nine. Are you getting the point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what about this base? So, ETF software will by default give the base level. And this base level ETF software considering as foundation level. ETF software is considering this base level is as foundation level. So, always keep in mind. So, we are considering that means you come to know. You are getting how you can count the total number of stories. Number of stories. Now, you also means getting the thing how you can say that the bottom story height. So, bottom story height is the measure of top of footing. One more thing I am going to add here. The top of footing, bottom story height will be from top of footing to the plinth level. So, it will become bottom story height. It will become what? Bottom story height. If suppose plinth level is not there, suppose the building is having the ground level as parking, if suppose the building is having the ground level as parking, then what will happen? See, this kind of elevation of the building is, suppose this is your foundation level, this is your ground level, and this is your first floor. Okay, so at the ground level, the parking is there. Car parking is there. Hello. So just tell me in that situation, in open story case, in open story case, there will be the presence of plinth. Hello.
Yes, sir.
In open story case or in the case where at the ground level parking is there. So let me know, plinth level will be there or not?
Sir, there will be tie beam, sir.
No, yeah, that's not the discussion. What I'm asking, just tell me, there will be the plinth? If the ground level is having the parking, is there will be the plinth? No. Hello.
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
Plinth will not be there. What? Plinth will not be there. So in that situation, bottom story height will become what? From the foundation level to the ground level will become what?
Bottom story height.
Are you getting my point or not? We are discussing some practical points. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir. So this is all done. Just come back to suppose this G+2 building. That the example that we have taken here. Suppose it is the G+2 building. The height story. The height consideration is what for this project. Let's consider this is your ground. This is your plinth. This is one, suppose this is a 1 foot, let's say 3 feet, it is 3 feet, it is 7 feet, it is 7 feet, and this is the 10 feet, 10 feet, and then, okay, let's say G+2 building it is, this is your, ground, this is your first, and this is your second, okay, and this is again 10 feet and this is your terrace level. Now let me know how many number of levels will be there. It is G+2 building. Hello.
Four levels.
Four,
yeah, exactly, there will be the 4 levels. So that just put it here as 4 numbers, 4 levels. Typical story height. So, typical story height means what? The height which is going to be repeat. The height which is going to be repeat. Okay. That we are going to call as typical story. For example, we are going to deal G+20 floor building. So, all the floor to floor height is, for example, all the floor to floor height is, for example, 3 meter, then 3 meter, 3 meter. But at some level, the height of the floor to floor height is going to be changed by 2.9. Hello. Rest of all floors are of 3 meter. Only one floor is having what? 2.9 meter height. Floor to floor height. Then what? The typical story height in this type of project, it will be what? 3 meter. Only one change is there. So the height which is going to be repeat, that we are going to call it as what? Hello.
Typical height.
Typical story height. Okay. We are going to call it as typical story height. So that we have to put here. So in this case, which height is going to be repeat?
10.
That's why I'm going to put it here as 10. And What is the bottom story height? Can you tell me what will be the bottom story height?
10. We have to merge it, sir.
10.
Exactly. We have to merge it. Very good. We have to merge this ground and we have to merge this plinth. And finally, we are going to take directly the total height like 10. So come back and put it here as 10 feet. So this is all done. But further, if you want to make any modification, there's no better clarification for you. So what you can go with the custom grid data option to look at the story definition. Just click over edit story. Yeah. So here it is the base. I would like to make the change like plinth. So change it to what? Sorry, plinth. It will be what? Plinth. This is your first level. This is your second level. And this is actually my terrace level. So that's why I'm going to change the name as terrace level. Okay. So this is all done. Is that all clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Further, if you want to make any addition, changes. Okay. By mistake, suppose this terrace height from the second floor is not at the 10 feet. So suppose it is at 9 feet. So I can change it to from 10 to 9. So that later modification you can also do. Is that all clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
And this will give you cumulative height. So total height of the building from the ground, I can say it is a 40. Is that all clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Just say simply, okay. So this is the definition over the height. And if you want the grids, just click over the grids. Now simply say okay. Once you click over the okay, so this will be now available. This will be available here. Is that all clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
But after having this center line or these grid lines, suppose for further modeling work, for the further action, I need to work with the SI system. I need to work with what? SI system, because if you are practicing for the Indian project, so in India we are assigning the load in what? Hello?
Kilonewton.
Am I right or wrong? In kilonewton. And most of the time we are working with the meter and mm and centimeter. That's also right or wrong? Hello?
Yes, sir.
But it will be very difficult for us if we are going to proceed with this US customary. But basically what we have done, initially we have selected the unit system as US customary. Then what? There will be the problem. So it's okay, no problem. Anytime you can change the unit system. You all are with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Here on right side bottom, look at this. Hello, units. Hello. Unit. Visible?
Yes, sir. Unit.
And change it to what? Metric SI default. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, let's see. It is changed. 3.048 in
meters.
Meters. Is that all clear?
Yes, sir.
At any stage, if you feel, I need to work with the feet and inches again for the modeling work, then again go back to units and change it to what?
US default.
So again, it is changed. Further, at any stage, if you feel, now I need to assign the load in kilonewton, then come back and change it to metric SI default, then it is going to be changed. Is that all clear?
Yes, sir.
Shall we proceed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is all about the formation of the grids for the uniform and for non-uniform for the simple geometry. Now just come back for some other examples are there. Now we have to prepare the grids. This grid we have to prepare. Hello.
Yes, sir.
This. So all the grids that we have prepared till now was in the Cartesian form in X and Y direction. We are going to call it as what? Cartesian grids. Now this is the form of cylindrical grid. This is the form of cylindrical grid. So this grid we have to prepare. So when you go to ETABS, just go to file, just say new model, say no, and go with the US built-in setting, use built-in setting with. So let me know, what is the unit? What is
customary,
the unit?
US customary.
No, no, here, here.
4 meters.
It is in SI system or US means feet and inches?
SI.
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 So we need to choose SI. SI. This then just click over the OK. Once you click over the OK, this dialog box will open. But one very important thing, if you look, so it is all the definition were demanded by this quick template for the Cartesian format. For the what? Cartesian grid. There is no any option to make grid in the form of cylindrical form. There is no any option to make the grids in the form of cylindrical. So we are not able to put the definition for the cylindrical grid. So in this situation, what you need to do, if the story data is there, that you can modify. If the story data is there, that you can modify. But in plant definition, you can't set. Because this is all for the Cartesian format. This is all for the what? Cartesian format. And our objective is what? We have to prepare the grid for the cylindrical format. But over the story definition, you can define. Okay, yeah, for this project, I need to put 5 number of stories. But typical story height, let's say 3.2 meter, 3.3 meter. Bottom story height, let's say 3 meter. So this is my story definition. But in plant definition, you can't set. Why? Because it is asking for the Cartesian format. And our grid is what?
Cylindrical.
So, what's the solution? So, there's no solution. Just click over the blank. Choose over the blank sheet. Just say OK after setting of story data. Okay? That you can set. And that will be, will form this number of stories with these heights, with defined heights. Okay? Simply say OK. Once you click over the OK, blank will be there, nothing will be there, and I don't need to have this 3D view. Just close this, only the plan view, and just come on the first story. So I'm at the on the first story. So go to file, go to edit, story grid system. Once you click over the edit story grid system, here we need to say add a new grid system. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Just click over add a new grid system. Once you click over the add, you see the basic grid is there. G1 grid is there. G1 grid system is there, which is blank. Now we need to add one more grid. Once you click over the grids, now see here two options are available. What you want? Either Cartesian or cylindrical. Hello.
Cylindrical.
Yeah, choose this one, cylindrical. So accordingly, some definition will be changed. Now, see, two directions are there for the cylindrical grid, radial direction and tangential direction. So along this X direction, this is the radial. This is what? Radial direction. This is what? Or radial direction. Along the X, I can say. And these are pink lines are actually what? Tangential directions. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Pink what? Tangential direction. So, in radial direction, how many number of grids are there? So, only half part we need to consider. So, how many grids are there? This is the one, this second, third, fourth, fifth. And this origin, six. One, two, three, four, five, and hello?
Six
numbers will be there. Only half part we need to consider. So just put it as labeling in radial direction were followed by the tabs like this: center to outward one option, and outward to inward. From inward to outward, from outward to inward. So basic is what? From center to outside, it is going to give the labeling to the grids like A, B, C, D, E, F in alphabetical order. And in tangential direction is giving the numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in clockwise direction. So this is the default setting. But if you want to make the change towards center. So the labeling is going to be done towards center. So A will be here, B, C, D, E, at the center you will get F. So this is the second option. And third option, for the tangential direction, this is the clockwise. And another option may be what? Counterclockwise. Counterclockwise. So what do you think? Would you like to change it or let it to be as it is? Hello?
As it is.
As it is. Okay. Okay. Now second one is the grid system origin and orientation. So you have some idea about this, where you want to put your grid, where you want to put these grids. So I don't want to shift my grid anywhere. So let it to be as it is, 0, 0. We will practice over this option later. Okay. Now next, number of grid lines in radial direction. So let me know how many number of grids are there in radial direction. Only the half part we need to consider. Hello.
Yes, sir.
How many grids are?
Six.
Six number of grids are there in radial direction. So change it to what? Six. Change to what? Six. Number of grid lines in tangential direction. So there is a formula to calculate the number of grids in tangential direction. So total angle from this first point to the another point. What is the total angle? Can you tell me what is the angle? Hello.
180.
180 divided by unit angle. Unit angle is what?
9 degrees.
Divided by 9 degrees plus 1. Sorry. 180 divided by 9 degrees plus 1. What is giving the answer? Hello.
21.
So total number of grids along the tangential direction will become 21. Change it to what? 21. Spacing of the grids in radial direction, as you know that it is a horizontal means distance measurement. Okay. So it is asking in meter, and in tangential direction it is the angle. So that's why it is asking in degree and angle. Okay. So go back and look at this. So what is the spacing in horizontal direction, or I can say in radial direction?
4.
So change it to what? 4. Put it as 4. Spacing of grids in tangential direction?
9 degrees.
Sorry?
9 degrees.
Yes, exactly. It will be the 9 degrees. Unit angle you need to put. Okay, unit angle you need to put between the two grids. So that is also done. Now simply say okay. And now say simply okay. See, the grids now available. Is that all clear?
Yes, sir.
If you want to improve the visibility of this grid, so go to edit grid system. Just choose the, now at this time, if you are going to click on this first, go to modify. So nothing will be there because we have not prepared any grid. Hello. So yes, that sir. Is not our required grid. Change this. Come to the second one. Now click over the modify. So this definition is there. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Change the color,
yes, sir,
to any dark color. Say okay. If you want to change the bubble size from 1250 to 1000. And now, see, if you want to change the color also, okay, let it to be as it is. Okay, okay. Now simply say okay. Is that all clear? In the 3D view, if you want to see, so this is the definition in the 3D view. Okay, hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, next, if you want, go to plan at any level. If you want to make these grids by some inclination, like at 30 degree, if you want to rotate it by 30 degree. So how you can do this? Go to edit story and grid system. Go to second one, go to modify, and see here rotation you need to put what? Hello?
30 degree.
Change to 30 degree. Then I would like to change the color from black to red. Change it. Say okay. Just take the 3D view. Is that all clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is another way. Go back to plan. Come to the any floor level. So just go to set display option. Edit story and grid system. Go to modify and change it. Say 0. Okay. Another thing. I would like to shift this grid from the origin. Initially, if you look, so the center is at the origin. At the center of the at 0, 0 level it is actually. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Suppose if you want to shift the center of the grid away from the center of axis, away from the origin. So what, I suppose I want to shift it in x direction by 5 meter and in y direction by 6 meter. Hello, in x 5 meter, in y 6 meter. So go to edit. Go to edit. Go to edit story grid system. Go to second. Go to modify story. And change it to 0. In x direction, how much?
5 meters.
5. In y, 6.
6 meters.
Say simply okay. Say okay. So it is going to, see, it is going to be shifted in x direction by 5 meter and in y direction by 6 meter. 6 meter. That's why this length is there. Is that all clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So this is a form of cylindrical grid. Now next example that you have to prepare the grid for, like this example. Hello. Now this grid we have to prepare in ETF software. Yeah. So how you can, okay, first tell me whether it is the Cartesian grid or a cylindrical grid. First.
Combination.
Combination, sir.
It is the combination.
Combination.
So, can you tell me how you can prepare this grid, because it is the complication. At the same time, you need to have cylindrical also, you need to have the Cartesian also, then tell me.
Sir, first we have to make that Cartesian grid, sir.
Okay.
Then we have to do that cylindrical part, and we have to tell the X and Y position, sir.
Very good, very good. So, would you like to see here or would you like to practice it? Tell me.
Here, sir.
Would you like to practice on your own or would you like to see here?
Sir, you can see this one, sir.
Will you see? Yes, yes, Shubham, sir.
Yes, sir.
What do you think? Malik Salman.
Yes, sir.
Would you like to see here or will you practice it?
Sir, we'll practice it.
Ibrahim.
Sir, my opinion is you just give us an example by drawing it, sir. And you tell another, the offset thing is there, sir, X and Y. You another offset, we will do on it our own, sir, as a practice. Yes.
Okay. Pranav. Hello.
Yes, sir. Same, sir.
Will you practice this?
You take the first example, sir. Then
okay. Means, would you like to see here? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. No issue, no issue. It's all for your convenience, for your understanding. Don't worry. Okay. So, we have to prepare this grid. Go back to ETABS. Go to File. Go to New Model. Say no. So, in the first case, don't consider this cylindrical grid. Don't consider this cylindrical. Only consider this normal grid. Okay. This is actually what? Cartesian format. In the Cartesian format. So, as usual, you have to proceed. So, first of all, you have to decide in which unit system the means your option, your question is actually. So, it is in metric SI. So, just go back and let it to be metric SI. Then say OK. Once you click over the OK, find out how many number of grids are there in X direction. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. 8 number of grids in X direction, change it to 8. Now, Y direction 1, 2, 3, 4, it is 4 actually. Change it to what? 4, let it to be. And spacing in X direction, it is not uniform. In Y direction, it is not uniform. So let it to be as it is, whatever actually present here. Go to custom one, go to edit grid data and go with the second option for the effective and for the ease and convenience. Go with the second option. Okay. And what is the spacing between C from this grid to this grid from G to H, because we are going to measure it from left. Don't do the mistake of measuring from right. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Always from left to right and bottom to top.
Top.
Okay. Now, 5.9, 10.2. 5.9, 10.2. 5.9, 10.2. If I 6. If I'm doing the mistake, let me know. Okay. 9.6, 5.3. 9.6. 9.6. 5.3. Next.
6.2.
6.2, 9.1. 4.9, 5.8, and next one 4.6, this is also done. Is there any other thing? No, change it to what? It will be let it to be 1000 and change the colors to take some dark
black.
say okay and there's no any discussion about the story, so let it to be as it is. Just click over the grid, say simply okay. Is that all clear? So it's very simple. How you can prepare the means the grids as normal grid in the form of Cartesian. Now, the second part that we have to add here is cylindrical grid. Hello?
Yes, sir.
This cylindrical grid. So, simple thing is what? Just go to edit. Go to edit story and grid system. And what? Can you guide me?
Add new grid system.
And here, the grid label is what? G2. And whatever you want, you can change the label. Okay, this is not means so you can call it as cylindrical also. S, you can write, or let it to be as it is. G2, CHI, whatever you want, you can put the name. Then choose the cylindrical one. Let the label as by default positioning. Okay.
No position changes.
Before of that, okay, we will see about the positioning later. Let it to be 0000. Come here. Number of grids in radial direction. How many number of grids in radial direction?
6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6. Very good. It is 1. Center, we are going to count as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Just go back to it as and put it as 6. And in tangential direction, how many number of grids will be there? 11. Total angle is what?
180.
And unit angle is actually not present here. It is actually 18 degree. It is what?
18 degree.
So put it as 18 plus 1. Total answer 11. Will become what?
11.
Number. Total number of tangential grids are 11. So change it from 4 to 11. And spacing of the grids in radial direction, how much?
2.
2. Change it to what? 2. And unit angle is what? Hello?
18.
So this is all done. Say simply okay. Say simply okay. Yeah. This grid is actually present at the origin because the distances and offsets, we have not giving any value. So that all values are 0, 0. So just tell me, is it okay?
Yes.
It is okay?
No.
No, we have to shift this cylindrical. Okay. So how you can shift this? So you need to
coordinate changes.
Consider it to be 0, 0. It is what? 0, 0. It is what? 0, 0. So we have to shift this grid somewhere here. So we need to have the distance x direction and y direction. So how you can measure this distances? So go back to your question, look at this. So vertical is very clear. At what height it is present?
4.9.
Add these all three values, let me know what is the answer.
22 4.9 5.2 5.3.
You are correct, but let me check it. How much it is? 15.3. Yeah. Y, yes, coordinate is what? 15.3. Exactly. And X coordinate is what? Sorry.
5.9, 10.2, 9.6, 5.3. 6.2. What half of this?
Do it.
5.9.
Add this all values. 5.9 plus 10.2 plus 9.6 plus 5.3 plus 6.2 plus 9.1 plus 3.9. Okay, just say equal
50.2.
And you have to subtract this value. Am I right?
Minus 10. 40.2.
Yes, 40.2. Exactly. Very good.
40.2.
Very good. Minus 10, it will become
40.2.
So y ordinate is actually 15.3 and x ordinate is actually what?
40.2
meter, and this is in meter. So this is all done. Come back to your tabs and go to editor. Go to edit story grid system. Go to second grid.
G2.
Go to modify. Very good. Go to modify, and no rotation is needed. Just x value will be what? 40.2. And y value will become 15.3. Yes, yes.
15.3.
This is all done. If you want to change the color to red one for change only, and let it to be all as it is, just say okay. Say okay. Is that all clear?
Yes, sir.
So like this, you can prepare the grids in the form of Cartesian, in the form of cylindrical, or in combination. So architecture plan may be different. Okay, it is not fixed only this kind of situation you need to face. Any kind of, because architecture plan may be different. Your home, amongst all of us, about how many we are, 24, 25 participants are there. So all the architecture plan of your home will be same, will be different. Obviously, so as grids will always be different. Okay, so you should be have an idea how you can prepare the grids in different format. Is that all clear?
Yes, sir.
So the first part we have completed, like OPM method, offset point method, that is not in use, and the second one is the ETABS quick template option, over which we have practiced lot for now. This is over. Now third option is what? Export and import.
So,
how to export the drawing from the CAD and how to import it, so that we need to look. Just close this. Go back to ETAB. Go to file. Go to new model. Say no. Okay, let me show you. Go back to open. Yeah, this is called as structural framing plan. This is called as what? Structural framing plan. So what does the structural framing plan? What things are present in structural framing plan? And how to prepare this structural framing plan? What complication, what difficulties are there while preparing the structural framing plan? So that's the point of discussion of a real life project that we will discuss later. Only the thing is what? After having the structural framing plan, we have to draw the center line plan. And again, while preparing the center line plan, lot of complication, lot of adjustments are there. So if you are practicing with these things, so lot of question will be there with you. So all your question you can ask in the later stage. Only the thing is what? Center line plan we are preparing, that center line will pass through the center of column or the center of beam. So what methods we have followed, that is not actually matter here. Only the thing is what? Finally, we are having the center line. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Because our objective of discussion nowadays is to how you can export, how you can import. That's it. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the thing is what? We are having this center line. Okay. So this center line we have to import. Import in ETABS software. So how you can import in ETABS software? So first thing, you have to export it, then you can import it. Okay. So to export it, first select this complete drawing. Before of that, it is important to know that the unit system. Okay, the unit system. So in which unit system this drawing is actually? It is in meter. Okay. Okay. So this is all done. Select all this drawing. Just say Control C. Copy this. Okay. Open a new CAD file. Close this. And take this drawing here. Just say Control V. Now it is asking about the location where you want to put it. This is very important. You can take anywhere like here. If you are taking away from the origin that is actually represented here, you are taking the you are putting your drawing away from the center point. So it will create the problem. How it will create problem, you will understand it later. But right now I am going to take it at the origin. So just say move this drawing. Select this first point and just say 0, 0. Can you repeat it once? What you have to put?
0, 0.
Just click enter. So this drawing will come. Yes, this drawing will come at the origin. I will let you know why I am taking this drawing at the origin level. Okay, but remember this step. After having this, we have to save this file in DXF format. Okay, tell me, what is the basic format of CAD drawing?
DWG.
But to import the drawing in ETAB software, your file format should be what? Should be
DXF.
DXF. Always remember, you have to save the file in the DXF format. Otherwise, you can't import the file in the ETAB software. That's why you have to save the file in DXF format. One more thing, you need to know in which layer this drawing is actually prepared. Name of the layer. So I am going to take here. So what is the name of the layer? Hello.
Center line.
So always remember, your layer should be in, you need to know in which layer. So all the center lines should be in one layer only. In one layer, whatever it is, either center, zero, whatever, that doesn't matter, but that should be in one layer. That's another check. So yeah, okay, all these lines are in one layer. Okay, so and the name of the layer also you need to know, center line. So this is all done, and go to file, go to save as, and go to desktop and create a new folder. And here, give the name as DXF01. What is the name of file?
DXF01.
I am going to give the name, and it is the drawing, the format is DWG. So change it to what? DXF. Change to what? DXF. And now say simply save this file in DXF format. The file has been saved. In the desktop, DXF01. Now open the ETAB software. Make sure that what is the unit system of your drawing?
Metric SI.
Okay. And now another thing. After saving this file, close this file. Otherwise, there will be the problem. Close this file. Now they say open. Say OK. Then is there any need to have any grid? Hello.
No, sir.
No, we don't need to have grid because we are going to import the grids. And story definition you can set. There is no problem for the setting of story definition. So if you want to set the story definition, that you can do. Okay. How many number of stories are there? Hello.
Four.
Okay. Remember. Then go to blank. Choose the blank option. Say simply okay. Once you click over the okay, two windows will be there, like plan view and 3D view. And at what level we are? Can you tell me?
Story 4.
Remember, at story 4, go to file, go to import. import. And here BXF floor plan. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Just click over this option. Go to where this file, where the file is saved actually.
New folder.
New folder to DXF01. Say open. Once you click over the open, so coordinate system. In which coordinate system you want to import? So it is obviously G1 is there only. Are you getting my point? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Now second. DXF file format is what? Meter, feet, inches. What is it actually?
Meter.
Change it to meter. We want to import that lines as a beam. Hello.
Yes, sir.
We want to import that lines as a beam. And what is the layer name?
Center line.
Check this center line. And you don't need to consider all these others. Let it to be as it is. Then a beam property, we are not interested to import any beam property. Let it to be as it is. And at what level you want to put your center line? At what? At story 4, 3, 1, 2, what?
Sorry, 1.
Change it to 1. Now simply say OK. Very important, say OK. Once you click over the OK, so it is asking to save this model first. OK, no problem. Say it is as 101. Save this model. So we are not able to see in plan view. Yeah, 3D view it is visible. Why we are not able to see? Because you are at the story 4. We need to come at the first story. Say story first, say apply. Now you are at the, see how means easily you are getting all these things. You don't need to define any grid lines. Is that all clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Understood?
Sir.
But that is not, this is not the end. This is not the end. What earlier, in the last session I told you, if your model is correct, then all the later steps and later action will be correct. But if your model is wrong, all the later actions will be what?
Wrong.
So you need to check whether the file is imported, it is right or wrong. So check the distance. What is the distance between these two lines? 3.34. Go back to ETABS and check the distance for this. So how you can check this? Go to draw dimension line. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Draw dimension line. Now close this. This is the first point. Freely move to the next second point and don't click over that. Otherwise, the dimension will be drawn. Will be available here. We just want to check it. So it is 3.3435. Is it right or wrong? Hello.
Right.
It is right?
Okay.
Okay. So this is the way how you can check it. Is that all clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So another thing I would like to show you. Why I have taken this center, your plan at the origin in CAD. That you would means important. Okay. So go back to your G2 and go to desktop, go to new folder 2 and DXF, open this DXF file, and I'm going to take it away from here to anywhere like here. Now it's okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I'm going to save this file in DXF format. Save this file. Instead of taking at origin, I am going to put that 2 away from origin. Okay?
Origin.
Save this file. What problems you will face if this kind of practice you are going to do, that I would like to show. Say yes. Now, save this. Now close this. Say no. Now come back to ETABS again. Go to file. Go to import. Can you guide me? How I can import that file?
DXF file floor plan.
Wait. Go to file. Go to new model. Say OK. Go to blank. Say OK. Now let me know what I need to do first.
File.
Go to file. OK.
Import.
Import then.
DXF file floor plan.
Floor plan.
OK. Very good then. we have to where I say file, the then say open.
Open. Then central line.
Beams.
Central. Unit, sir. Unit is meters.
Okay, meter. Okay, next.
Story one.
Next. Okay. Say simply okay. What? You have to save this. Okay. Overline. Okay. Zero, so if you want to change it.
02.
Say save this file. Okay. Why we are not able to see this?
Story one.
First plan. Come at this story first. Say okay. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir. But coordinates is not. Axis were there.
Yeah, axis is not that. It is away. Okay. See, your axis is somewhere at other location, and your. So suppose I am going to walk over this. Now moving to the next level. I am coming to the next level from first. Look at this. From first to second. Now from second, I am coming back to first. So it is going to be the size is going to be changed. Again, I need to zoom it. Then I will walk, moving to the next level, coming back. Moving to the next level, then I am coming back to story first. So the size is going to be changed again and again. So what is the problem? Because I have not taken the plan at the zero level, at the origin. Are you getting? So always while saving the file in DXF format, your plan should be at what?
Zero. Origin.
Understood? Is that all clear?
Yes, sir.
Hello? Yes. Now come back. Say no. The next is what? It is in feet and inches. Hello? The same drawing. It is in what?
Yes, sir.
Feet and inches. Now, we have to save this file in DXF format first. So, how to do that? First, select this. Say Ctrl-C. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Open a new CAD drawing.
CAD.
Okay. We are not going to because a lot of things we need to do. Close that. We are directly going to save this file in DXF. Go to file, save as, in the form of what? Hello?
DXF.
Go to file, go to save as this file in the form of DXF at the desktop. Folder 2. And this. And level I am going to give as 2. DXF 02. Save this file. Okay, just remember, what is the distance, what is the length of this line? Hello?
And 10 feet.
10 feet 11 inches. And second thing, what is the unit system?
Hello? Inch and feet. Feet and inch.
Feet inches.
US default or US customary? Okay, so go back to the tabs, go to file, go to new model. Go to second one. What system will be there? US?
US
customary. Say okay. Once you click over the okay, is there any need to have the grid option?
No.
Choose the blank one. Say simply okay. Once you click over the okay, see, these files are open. Open. If you are trying to import it, then you will be in trouble. Go to file. Go to import. Go to a DXF file floor plan, click over that, DXF 02, say open. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Unable to open the file because what is the reason? Because file is in, file is actually opened. You need to close it first. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Are you getting my point or not?
Yes, sir.
Go to file. Okay. Now then go to file, etabs, go to file, go to import and floor plan, choose the second file, say open. Once you click over the open, which one? Center line. Check this. What is the unit system?
feet.
Feet and feet. Inches. So small value we need to put it is in inches actually. Put it in inches and it will be what? Story 1.
Story 1.
Is that all clear? Say simple. Yes, sir. Okay. And save this file.
03.
Change to 03. Now simply save this file. Go to plan. At story level first. Is that all clear?
Yes, sir.
But the thing is what? We need to check the dimension. So go to draw. Go to draw dimension line.
Draw dimension line.
Now close this. This is the first point. Really move.
Yeah.
How much it is? 10 feet. 11 inches. So it is actually representing in feet. So 9.6 will become 11 inch if you convert it.
Mm.
Is that all clear?
Yes, sir.
Is it right or wrong?
Yes, right.
So this is the way how you can export the drawing from CAD and how you can import the drawing in ATAP software. Is there any question about this action and how you can export it, how you can import it? Shubham sir.
Yes sir, no.
Pranav.
No.
Pratik.
No sir.
No question. Vaibhav, are you there? Vagnish?
No sir.
Is there any question?
No sir.
Ramesh?
No sir.
Okay, shall we proceed? This is all about the first section we have completed, like how you can prepare the grids in ETAP software. Yes.
Sir, when we import the model from AutoCAD, sir, there is no any grid line, sir. Do we use any reference line or elevation at that time?
Sorry?
Sir, when we import the AutoCAD drawing, when we use the grid lines, in grid lines, we get automatically elevation A side, B side, C side.
Yes, sir, when we automatically get it.
Yes, sir. When we import the AutoCAD drawing, sir, it is not automatically getting the elevations, sir. How can we get the elevations in when we import the drawings, AutoCAD drawings?
No, elevation will also be there in reference of your grids.
Sorry. No, sir. He is asking like the grid level is there, na, sir. A, B, C, like that. That's he is asking, sir.
Grid levels, Malik Salman. You are asking for that.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes,
yeah.
Sir.
So, actually, see.
Grid labeling.
Grid labeling, you are asking. Okay, that labeling. Is not needed. Why we are taking the center line? Because our intention is what? Okay, let me show you. Oh, good question. Good question. Sorry, wait. Yes, see. No, sorry. See, Salman.
Yes, hello. Sir.
Yes, our intention is what? To put the columns at its right position. Okay? So, after having this center line, there is no need to have the grid reference. You don't need to have the grid reference because directly you are getting the intersecting point to put your column. Why we are taking the grids, like why we are taking the labels of the grid, so that you can find out the points. You can find out the points, sir. Then you can put your column over that point. But in the center line plan, if you are going to export it and you are going to import in the ETAP software, directly the intersecting point you are getting, you just need to look to your center line plan along with its column position. And accordingly, you have to position your column in ETAP software. Are you getting?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Are you getting or not?
Yeah, yes, 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 sir. I'm getting.
Yeah. Okay. Is there any other question?
I'm not.
Hello.
Sir, can you hear me?
Yes, Pranav. Is there any question?
Yes, sir. Column or not clear.
Sorry. Echo is there, Pranav. Fast, tell me.
Column position point is not clear, sir.
See, all only try to understand. You learn how to export and how to import. Hello.
Yes, sir.
That's only the objective of taking this. Later all how to column position decide, how to whether it is at the center or not. That's all practical discussion. We will discuss it at the time of real life project. Okay? If you are trying, okay. I'm going to take everything at this point. So that is not okay. That will not be means easily understandable for you all. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. That's why I'm saying what the topic is ongoing. Ask about that thing only, because lot of things are there, and that all things will come time by time. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yes. Okay, so let's close this all. We have to move for the next section. So can you wait for 2 minutes? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, wait for a minute.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now coming back. The next part that we have to start. Validation. Hello. Next exercise, yes, actually, sir. The validation of the software, some simple structures and models we are going to take, and we are going to check whether your software is giving the correct result or not. But that is not only the objective. Along with the software validation, a lot of things we have to learn, like how you can assign the load, how you can model the line element, what are the different types of the elements in the software, how you can assign the point load, live load, uniformly distributed load, okay, how you can check the forces, what is the axis consideration. So many things are there. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So learning outcome of this exercise will be what? After completion of this exercise, you will come to know what different types of axis system, how you can assign the loads, how you can see the loads, what type of the movements will be there, how to check the reactions, everything will be clear. Okay, so the first thing we need to understand, the axis system. What are the different types of axis? So basically there are three types of axis. There are actually three types of axis. First one is what? Global axis. Second one is what? Local axis. And third one is what? Hello. Natural axis. Can you repeat this once? Global axis is there, local axis is there, and hello, natural axis is there. How many of you are passing your masters?
Master.
Pratik?
Yes, Sammy.
Yeah, Pratik, tell me, what does mean the global axis? Ragnesh, what does mean the global axis, local axis, natural axis? Okay. Go back. So there are three types of axis system. One is your global axis, one is your local axis, one is your natural axis. So the axis system which is going to represent your entire model, the axis system which is going to be represent your entire model, that we are going to call it as global axis. Or in other way, we can define the system which is represented by a one axis system, that the structure or the model or the structure of the model which is going to be represented by a one unit system called as global axis. It means what? Your actual model will be consisting of too many elements. Like some elements will running along in one direction, some of elements will running in other direction, some of elements will running along another direction. Okay, so here if you look simple model, so these four columns, if I am going to call it as column, so all these four columns are running in z direction. Hello. So
yes, sir.
All
yes.
These elements were represented by one unit system, one axis called as what? All these elements are running along z direction. All the elements which is running along this direction, which is represented by one axis system as x. Hello.
Yes, sir.
And all the elements which is running along in this direction, we are going to call it as these all elements are along the y direction. So it is what? It is a solid element. It is a solid model. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Your model is actually solid. It is having three dimensions, in this direction, in vertical direction. So the elements which is running along this direction, we are going to call all elements along this direction. All the elements along this direction. All the elements along this direction. Okay. So we are going to call it as global axis. So the axis system which are actually going to represent your entire model called as what? Hello?
Global axis.
Now come to the next part, as this is called as global axis. This is what? Local axis. This is what? Local axis. So in local axis, see, if you go inside of your model, so each element is also a solid element. Like if you are talking about this beam, so beam is solid element or not? Solid means what? Yes, it is, sir, having the three dimension. Suppose the beam you are taking like this, beam you are taking, so it is having its length, it is having its width, it is having its depth or height, whatever you want to say, depth or height. This is the width, this is the length. So it is solid element or not?
Yes, sir.
It is further solid element. So to define all this dimension, this element should also have its own axis system. Hello. Am I right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
This element should also have its own axis system. And that axis system we are going to call it as, hello.
Yes, sir.
Local axis.
Local axis system, exactly.
Local.
So all the elements like column. Column is also having its own axis system. Three axis. Beam is having its own axis system. If slab is also there, let me show you. Yeah. Suppose if you are talking about the beam. So, yes. Length, along length, one axis is there. Along width, another axis is there. Along depth, another axis is there. So this is the axis for beam. This is axis beam. So each element is actually solid element. It's having its three dimension. To define its three dimension, three axis is actually needed, and that axis we are going to call it as local axis for the beam, local axis for the column, local axis for the slab. Is that all clear?
Yes, sir.
Local axis for the slab. Now if you move one more step inside of this beam or column or slab, whatever, so this element, it is made up of small particles, solid particles. Like if you are talking about see here, this beam is made up of accumulation of small solid particles, right or wrong? Hello.
Yes, sir. Coarse aggregate, fine
this
aggregate.
Further, this further is solid element. It is having its three dimension. And for representing its three dimension, you need to have the axis system. So these small solid particles with which this your element is actually formed by the accumulation of these small solid particles, this having its own axis system, and that we are going to call it as what?
Natural axis.
Natural axis. So these three axis systems will be there. One is your global axis system, one is your local axis system, and third one is your natural axis system. Is that all okay, Pratik?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Clear. So three axis system is there. So in ETAP software, you will be able to see global axis, you will be able to see local axis, but normally you are not able to see natural axis system. Okay, this is for your information, for your knowledge only. Only the required and for our action, for our use, two axis system we need to look. One is your global axis, one is your local axis. These two axes. Let me show you. Okay, take the 3D view. Okay, let me open any model. See, the axis system you are getting here, it is what? Can you tell me?
Global axis. Global
it is axis. What? Global it axis. Is actually global axis, which is representing your entire model, which is representing your entire model, each element. So all the elements, it doesn't matter whether it is beam, column, whatever, and links, spindle, whatever. The element which is running along this direction, what you will tell? All that elements are along what?
Global axis.
Global axis in a?
X-axis.
X-direction. Yes. All the elements, it doesn't matter whether it is a beam, column, slabs, whatever. If suppose it is running in this direction, what you will tell?
Y-direction.
In Y-direction. And all the elements, it doesn't matter what type of element. If suppose its orientation, suppose in this direction, what you will tell?
Z-direction.
So it is going to be represented by one global axis system. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Sir. Now come to the plan at any level. Go to set display option. How to look at how to see these all. I will explain it all this in detail in the command section. See. Now, this is the representing for the beams. This is a local axis for what? Hello.
Beam.
These beam. Are the local axis for beams. Let me show beam, you from beam. Here. These are the local axis for beam. Hello.
Beam.
This is for beam. And local beam. Axis for what?
Column.
Column. This is local axis for column. This is local axis for beam. Clear?
Means slab.
Okay. Yes, and now, if you want to see the local axis for slab also, so go back. Go to set display option. Of this and local axis say apply. Is it visible? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is the local axis for
slabs?
Slabs. Is that all clear? What does it mean by the local axis and global axis and local axis?
Clear, sir. Clear.
Clear? Clear. So very important. Now, next thing. Okay, what are the different types of elements we are considered by the ETAP software? Do you have any idea what are the different types of elements? Hello?
Solid elements.
No. There are two types of elements were considered by the software.
Yes.
One is your line element. Or we can say frame element. Hello. Remember, very important point.
Yes, sir.
Line yes, sir. Element. Close this. Line element or a line. Sorry, actually it is what? Frame element. frame, element, and second one is what?
Element. Shell.
Element. These two types of elements were considered by the ATAP software. Remember, so frame element will include all the line elements. All the line elements. Line element means what? Your beams, your columns, your spindles, your links. These all are what actually? Hello?
Frame element.
Frame element or line, frame element actually. Why we are calling it as line element? Because in comparison of its sectional dimension, suppose if you are talking about the beam. So beam may be of length 5 meter. For example, the beam of length of 5 meter and the width is 230 and depth is 450 mm. And 5 meter will become 5000. So in comparison of its length, its other two dimension is very small. Am I right or wrong? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
That's why we are going to call it as line element. Actually, it is solid element. Okay. It is having the three dimensions. But why we are calling it as frame? Because these other two dimensions are very small in comparison of its third dimension along its length. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Likewise, if you are talking about the column. So, the column is having the height like suppose 3 meter. It's suppose 3 meter height of the column which will become 3000 and it is what? So kindly mute your mic. Okay. See, suppose this is the 230 by 230. Suppose it is 450 and it is what? 230. 230 by 450 section size of the column is there and the height is 3000. So if you look this two dimension in comparison of this, so it is looking very small and is more. That's why we are going to call it the column as what? Hello? As?
Line element.
Line frame element. Element. Or you can say frame element. Now, next is what? The slab. If you are taking this slab, the slab is having actually suppose two dimension of the slabs. In plant dimension of the slab is suppose here it is 4 meter. Or it is 5 or you can say 6 meter. So 6000 and it is what 4000 and depth of the slab is actually what let's say 150 mm. So is there any comparison between 6000 and 150? Tell me.
Variation.
Very large difference is there. That's why we are going to consider it as area element. Hello?
Yes, sir.
That's why we are considering as area element and the software giving the name to this element as shell. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Is that all okay? Sir. So slab, it will in area element or shell element will include your slab, shear wall. This all we will consider as a shell element and all other like beam, column, spindle, we are going to consider as a frame element. This is all clear? Hello?
Yes. Clear, sir.
Is that all clear? Is there any question and doubt? Hello? Hello? Roma?
No, sir.
Yes, sir. Listening, sir.
Are you getting or not?
Yes, sir. Getting, sir.
Is there any question, doubt?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Yes. Shall we proceed?
Definitely.
Yes. Now, next. Okay. So, we have to model this truss. Hello. We have to model this truss. But while in your bachelor's, in your diploma, in your master's, you might be solve this kind of example manually. Am I right or wrong? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So, for analyzing and for dealing this kind of truss, so some assumptions are there. Am I right? Some assumptions are there. So, have you remember what assumptions was? for analyzing and designing the truss. Shubham sir, Vivek, Pratik, Vajad.
Sir, we have to take the sign conventions for shear force and bending moment.
Okay. Assumptions I am asking.
Before that, we have to check the redundancy of the frame, sir.
No. I am asking about the assumptions of the analysis of the truss. Pranav.
The section remains same before and after bending. Like that you are asking.
Yeah. But that's
sir, all the loads are on the point, only acting on the points of the joints actually.
Exactly, this is the right one. First one, another, this is the one. Okay, likewise, 4 to 5 assumptions are there. Out of them, Ruma said right first, all the loads will be only at the points. What it means that, let's see, the loads is going to be act only at the intersecting point. Only at the intersecting point, you will not be able to see the point at any intermediate level, position in between of these two points. So yeah, here it is looking, but it is actually at this point. Okay, don't be confused. Okay, so in case of truss, all the loads is going to be act at the joints only. Clear?
Yes,
hello.
Sir.
Now, okay. Second assumption. Tell me fast. Okay, let me explain to save the time. Okay, so all the load is going to be act at the intersecting point of the two frames at the joints only. First thing, all the elements will be of uniform cross section. All the elements will be of uniform cross section. So for this truss frame, for this truss element, the section size will be same throughout its length from the start point to the end point, and all the frames are going to be connected at their ends only. Hello. In case of truss, you will not find the one frame is going to be connected at the mid of the other frame. Okay. All the frames are going to be connected at their ends only. Hello. Second assumption.
Yes, sir. Yes.
The cross section will be same. Loads will be at the intersection point, and the connection will be at their ends, and we are going to neglect the self weight of the truss in the analysis while manual calculation. What? Hello? Self weight of the elements we are going to neglect.
Neglect.
Is that all clear?
Clear, sir.
Self weight we are going to neglect. Loads are going to act at the points. Connection will be there at their ends. Cross section size will be same. Now, the most important, the connection between these two ends will be what? Pinned connection. Hello. This connection will be what? Pinned connection, or I can say hinged connection. Hello. Hinged connection. Will you repeat these ones?
Yeah.
This connection will be what?
Hinged
or pinned connection it will be. It will not a rigid connection. It will not be fixed connection. It will be what? It will be hinged connection. What is the use and what the application of this assumption? You will understand, and you will understand also the importance of this assumption in ETAB software. So I hope this assumption is very important. Let me show you. Okay. Weight of the member can be neglected. All members have uniform cross section. All external forces are applied only at the joints. All members have only axial forces. These are very important. All the members will be subjected to only axial forces, and the nature of the force may be either tensile or compressive.
Compressive.
Okay. Two types of nature of load will be there. Means suppose if you are taking any frame of your truss, so this frame may be subjected to tensile force or compressive force. Hello. This is the tensile and this one is the compressive force. Understood? Members
yes,
are connected at the joint through the pinned connection. The two members are going to be connected at their ends only, and this connection will be what? Only the pinned connection and only the hinge connection. What does mean the pin connection? What does mean the hinge connection. I will explain it. I will explain. Is that all clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
sir. Now, my another question, whether it is the elevation or is the plan view, what is this?
Elevation view.
It is the elevation view, exactly. So, go back. We have to prepare this. So, for to model this, we can't directly model it. We need to prepare the grid lines. We need to prepare the grid lines, reference lines. So, go to file, go to new model, say, go to custom. Let me know, what is the unit system? Sorry.
Metric SI.
Good. Go back to ETABS, change it to metric SI. Let it to be as it is, say okay. Let me know how many grids will be there along X direction.
Four.
Okay. The thing is what? Three axis system, three, means this X, this Y, okay, and this is what? Z. First, decide in which plane this means model is there. So, I would like to say this is in X and Z plane. Hello?
Yes, sir.
X and? Or you can consider Y and Z plane. It's your choice. What you want to consider? Either in X, Z or Y, Z.
X, Z.
X, Z plane. Okay. So, if you are looking from the top, how many grids will be there?
Seven
grids. Okay. Anyone else? Fast.
Three, sir.
Okay. Anyone else? Fast.
No,
you are doing the mistake. This is the baseline. And this, if you are considering, this is over the height. And this is the baseline. Now, something will be clear to you. Tell me, how many grids will be in plan? Along X?
Three.
Again, doing the mistake. Three.
Four.
This one, this two, this three, this will be four. Don't consider this. This is the over height. This is the story data. Hello. Are you getting my point?
Okay.
This is the in plan. That doing the mistake you are. Understood? Along X? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Go back to ETABS. Along X direction it will be four. What about along Y? See, try to understand.
Zero.
Important point. No, not zero. This line is actually along X also. Along Y, one line is there. If I'm taking another, along Y will be two. If I'm taking another, along Y will be three. But this line is actually along X and at Y. Hello, can I say this? Hello.
Yes, sir.
So it will be Y, one. Because you can't put zero number here. Understood? Hello? Put it as one. Spacing in X direction, how much it is?
Four.
Typical spacing, it will be four. In Y, you can't put zero value, so put it as only one. Understood? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, is there any need to go to custom for in-plan definition? Tell me. Fast. Hello. Is there any need to go to custom? Hello.
No, sir.
No. Need to be. And what? Story data. Story definition. So, ETABS will by default will consider it the foundation level, or we can say base level. So, don't worry about this. How many levels will be there in addition to that? One and?
Two.
Go back to ETABS and put it as number of story as two. What will be the height? Tell me. What will be the height? Hello. This is the first height. This is the second height. So, how you can calculate these heights? Do you have any formula?
Pythagoras theorem.
Find out this. So, this angle is actually what? 30 degree.
Right angle.
30 degree, and this base is how much?
2 meter.
We need to calculate this height. How you can calculate this height? Hello.
Opposite by adjacent.
Exactly. Opposite by adjacent. Okay. So 10 30 will equal to opposite by adjacent. Opposite is your h divided by 2. 2 will come here. Okay. So h is equal to 2 times 10 30. Give me answer.
1.1.
Hello.
1.15.
Check it once. Let me check it. You are doing mistake, I think. 2 times
10 30.
Yeah, 1.1547. What? How much it is?
1.1547.
Not total height. Total height. How you can calculate the total height? So it is 4 plus 2. How much it will become? 6. 6 times 10 30. 6 times 10 30 will give you total height. Let me know what is the answer.
3.464 meter.
3.464 meter. 3.464 41 is the total height. Now take the subtraction from this 1.15547. Tell me what is the answer.
2.
Sorry. Minus 1.1547. Say answer. How much it is? 2.3094.
3094.
So the first height. Okay. Remember these 2 points. 1.1547. First height x1. Sorry, y1. And this will be the z1. And this will be the z2. Is equal to 2.3094. These two heights are there only. Go back to ETABS. Okay, go back to ETABS. Go to file. ETABS. Is there any problem with the story? So don't worry. Just go to custom only. Go to story data. Base will be at 0. First height is at a distance of what?
1.1547.
Second height is at a distance of what?
2.3094.
So total height will become 3.4641. Is it right or wrong? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Right. Right.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So like this, you have to change it. Now simply say okay. Now simply say okay. Once you click over the okay, so yeah, this is now available. We need to look only the plan view. So we are at the plan view. Only one grid is there along y direction, along x direction. But our intention to work in elevation. In elevation. So I need to look elevation along the grid first. What? Along the grid first, I would like to see the elevation. So go to elevation along the grid first, say apply. Is that all clear? Hello. Once more, go to plan, come to any story level. I need to look the elevation along the grid first. So go to elevation along the grid first, say apply. Okay. Hello. Why you are not answering?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Is there any question, Pranav?
No, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So we have to start the modeling for this truss. Very, very important, and lot of things we need to learn. Okay. So, yeah. Actually.
Somebody is looking at a frame, sir.
Sorry?
It is looking like a frame, sir, but not like a truss.
No. This is only the grids. It is not the model. Hello.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it is only the grid. Okay. Who is asking? Hello.
Sir?
Yeah. See, it is just a grid. It is not the model. Without of having grid, how you can prepare the model? I told you. These are the reference lines. That will help you to find out the points to give the reference lines only. Okay, this is not the model. Okay. Take the line element. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Take this line element and close this. We have to start the modeling. Okay. So, look at this. Close this. Go to ETAPS and go to this question. Okay. So, yeah. The frame is from A to B, then B to C, then C to D. So, how to model the frame element? So, clear this all. Go to take the frame. Here it is visible. Hello. Draw beam, column, braces, or simply we can say frame element or line element. Hello. Just click over this. Now close this. This is the first point. Click over that. Freely move to the next point where you want to end your line. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Click over that. So this frame is going to be modeled here. Is that okay? But the action is not continue. Your command is not continue. If you want to off the continuity, you just right click on your mouse. So the continuity will be off, but the command is active. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Again, you can use this command to model the beam or line element or frame element like this. Now continuity is there. So you can take the help of this continuity for modeling of next element, then click over that. But beyond of that, I don't need to keep it to continue. Suppose, okay, undo this. I am going to start the modeling from this side. This is the first point. So really move to the next point. Hello. Then the command is continue. Sir. If you want to off this, and if you don't want to model it next element, so what you need to just right click. So the continuity will be off. But if you use the continuity, so in once you can model all these lines. First, then take the help of continuity. Click over the another point. Sorry, undo. Undo. In the first point, freely move to the next point. Then freely move to the next point. Then come to the next point. So in once you can model all these line elements. Understood? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, next, very important, when you are going to click over any particular point, don't click over that unless and until you are not getting this kind of red sign. Hello? Otherwise, what will happen if you are going to fire from like in this type and you are getting the point and you are not going to zoom it, and you are not going to correct exact position of the point, then what will happen? There will be error in your model, there will be warning in your model, and your model will be wrong. That's why, unless and until you are not getting this point and this kind of sign, like grid point, B1, story level, then click over that to avoid the errors. Understood? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the first point. Now another, click over this first point, another, here, from here, next point I need to put here, somewhere here, but I am not able to get the center point. Is it visible?
No.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
No. I am not able to get the center point. Then, because I have to take this line at the center, but I am not able to get this center point. Why? So, off this command by clicking over this select object, so your command of modeling the beam or line element is off, right click on this window. Hello, you are with me? Right click on this window, go to snap option, and make sure that line ends and midpoints is checked. Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Line ends and midpoints should be checked. Say apply. Now close this. Again, take the frame element. Now close this. This is the first point. Freely move to here. Now see, midpoint you are getting or not? Like your cat?
Yes, sir.
Okay? Click over this point. And if you want to make it continue, take it to this point again and now close this. Is that okay? Hello? Now again continuity is there. Right click on your mouse, so your continuity will be off. Hello? Next element. It is at what? It is at this level. So, yeah. At this level, the point you are getting, click on this first point, freely move and then click over this point, right, right click, this is the point and just click here, okay, hello,
yes sir,
now yes. From this point, take the line to this point of the continuity, click on this first point, freely move to this point, this is done. Is that all okay? Your model is ready now? Hello? Look at the question.
Yes, sir. Ready, sir.
It is ready?
Yes,
but one mistake is there. Hello? One mistake is there. What was our assumptions? All the elements are individual elements. Like from point to point, they are separate. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Point to point, they are separate. There will be no situation like this. Suppose a frame is there or truss element is there and the next, suppose this is its end, this is its end and another element is going to be connected with this frame element at its mid. So is it okay?
Awesome.
No. All the members are going to be connected at their ends only. Hello? But the situation is what? If you are looking here, if you are looking here, sorry, this frame and this element, so this is the complete frame and this frame is going to be raised at the mid of span of this main beam, main line element, right or wrong? Hello? Is it right or wrong?
Wrong.
It is wrong. So wrong. Assumption is what? All the members are going to be connected at their ends only. So we need to correct it. Okay. So actually this is all about today. We are going to stop our discussion here. We will start this example by tomorrow again. And lot of things actually we have to discuss for this example. If I am going to keep it continue. So it takes again half an hour at least. Okay. Lot of things we have to discuss.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Is there any other question for the today's discussion? You can ask me. Hello.
Just one technical question, sir.
Yes, you can ask.
Sir, what is the use of p-delta analysis in the ETAB?
That's not what? A point of... Okay, we will discuss it. You can contact me personally because that is not topic of... That I will cover in the HRI structure, okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, you can ask me the topic that we have covered today.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so this is all about today. We will meet tomorrow at 7:30 and recorder session will come to your mail, okay? So today, tomorrow and today's session will come by today evening probably. Is that okay? And
yes,
all
sir.
The study and
yes,
practice
sir.
Material will be shared on Telegram. The yesterday's materials I have shared. You all got that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Shall we conclude the session?
Yes, sir.
Now you all can leave the meeting.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.